Psalm 23, a very familiar passage of scripture. Amen. I think everybody knows this one. You can even recite it by heart, as they say. Amen. Hallelujah. So let's get started. It says, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Oh, glory. We can just stop right there. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Lord, we thank you. Woo, glory, God. We thank you for your word, which is already anointed, already blessed. Father God, I pray right now that whatever you have desired, oh Father God, whatever you predestined, even before time, God, that whatever the words were that would come up out of Mary, oh God, I pray right now, Father God, that I speak those words into the atmosphere. I thank you, Father God, for your word falling on fertile soil in the name of Jesus, God. Let it do whatever you purposed it to do in the name of Jesus. So, God, we glorify you. We magnify you, Lord. So, God, have your way in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. You may be seated. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Woo, Shandaro Bashita. Woo, glory to God. I told Marilyn, I said, well, let's just worship. I'm like, everything in this psalm is worship. I thank God. I first want to thank God, and I want to thank my pastors for asking me to bring the word and in their absence. And sometimes I'm a little bit hesitant, whether you know it or not, I really am. But glory to God, give him praise. And I was like, Lord, what on earth do you want me to talk about? And I believe the Lord just wants to affirm some things to you today. Amen. I don't think it's anything that you don't already know. I think he just wants to remind you who you are. I think he just wants to remind you what he wants to do for you. And sometimes it just doesn't get done. So he is the good shepherd. Amen. The word said he's the good shepherd. I know in this psalm, David is talking. You're familiar with David. You know, David was a sheep herder. And in the Bible, David loved the sheep. Even when he was going to be anointed king, he was out tending the sheep. All the other brothers were in the house because dad and the others were just so sure that one of them was who Samuel was looking for. But see, sometimes who you think should be anointed is not the one. And I'm going to tell you right now, by the unction of the Holy Spirit, that there are going to be a lot of people that you think ought not to be up front. And I'm going to tell you that this year, in 2018, they're coming up front. They're going to be recognized. They're going to be recognized by God, whether you like it or not. Amen. And they're going to be recognized because God said so. Because God wants to use them. And he's been hiding them. Oh, glory to God. But he's going to bring them out front. When God brings you out front, no man, I'm going to say it, in hell can stop you. Nobody can stop you if God says so, because God is sovereign. Amen. So we give him glory today. But we know David was a sheep herder. So we know he was tending the sheep. And we know that sheep is they're a funny animal. You know, the Bible says they dumb. But I'm going to tell you this. They had sense enough to follow the shepherd. Amen. Call them dumb if you want to. And the Bible says the Lord calls us his sheep. He's the good shepherd.
Yes.
And I'm not calling you dumb. I'm just saying that's what people say, that sheep are dumb. Because they will follow you straight off of a cliff if you lead them that way. But there are some particular things that I want to talk to you about the sheep. Because, see, they only like to follow one leader.
Come on now.
That ought to shout right there. That'd be something you ought to shout about. As a good shepherd, because, see, that's what God wants from us. He doesn't want us over here, over there. He only wants us to follow him. Amen.
Yeah.
Glory to God. So they have that much sense. Call them dumb if you want to. They follow. They don't like to follow but one leader.
Amen.
And if it's a ram in the bunch, they prefer to follow the ram. Now, I don't know if you know, the ram is the male sheep.
Yeah.
You know, I studied and I realized, I was like, what's all these names? I just want to make sure you all understand the lambs, the sheep, and the muttons, and haggards or something, I think is what they're called. But anyway, it depends on their age.
Amen.
As to what they're called.
Amen.
So, you know, in the Bible, Jesus told Peter, he says, feed my lamb. You mean you don't feed my lamb?
Yes.
Well, see, a lamb is less than a year old. It's a sheep. But it's less than a year old. And see, lambs like milk. You know? And spiritually, some of us are on milk, might be still on milk. We might ought to be off milk if we want to go by a year. You've been saved, you know the Lord. But anyway, lambs drink milk. And they drink it from what's called Eves. That's how I pronounce it. E-W-E-S. I'll spell it for you in case I'm pronouncing it incorrectly. And that's the mother. That's the female sheep. Okay, so then we have sheep who are over a year old, and then we have sheep who are like over two. So we give God praise for his word. And of course, the ram is the male sheep. So God is saying, I am the good shepherd. And he wants us to realize that there are so many benefits, so many things that he wants to give us. Now, some of us get a little skittish sometimes and with the things that go on in life, with the obstacles, with the reports from the doctor, with what's going on your job. Maybe you don't like what's going on in school. Get a little skittish. Well, that's how sheep are sometimes. That's why they need a shepherd, because the shepherd has to keep them in line. The shepherd is the one who reassures them that it's okay. You don't have to be skittish. You don't have to fear. I'm right here with you. I don't care where you go. I don't care what your circumstances are. I don't care what your situation is. I'm right here with you.
Amen.
That's because Jesus is the good shepherd. He said that if it wasn't, he says when he comes, you know, when they were shepherding the sheep, the sheep will follow the shepherd when he leaves.
Mm-hmm.
They'll get right up where they are. If they know their shepherd is going out, they get right up and fall in line and follow him.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let me tell you something else about a sheep. They know the faces of their shepherd. They got a very keen sense of that.
Amen.
They have very keen hearing.
Amen.
As well. That's why their only protection from predators is the fact that when they hear noises and when they hear, they don't like loud sounds. So when they hear them, they rally together. When trouble comes into camp, that's what they do. They get together. They got their butt up against each other because they do like a circle, and that's how they protect themselves from the predators. You know, what about us? Do we rally together when somebody's going through something? Or do we let them stand over there alone all by themselves? Or do we say, hey, let's have a prayer meeting, or let's call their name on the prayer line because sister so-and-so is going through something? There's strength in numbers, the Bible says in Ecclesiastes. You know? Hallelujah. Glory to God. But that's what the sheep do. They rally together when they have